You fight, you die. You obey, you die. You resist, you die. You desist, you die. You blink an eye, you die. You shake a leg, you die. You break a neck, you die. Your neck gets broken, you die. If being a Chinese soldier is a challenge, imagine being a Chinese army general. It's complete hell. Chinese generals are the ones who are tasked with carrying out Xi Jinping's diktats. And Jinping wants his diktats obeyed immediately in a manner he deems fit. And they must also bear positive results. If a general fails on even one count, he dies. One such general has died in China. We think he has been killed. Hi and welcome. This is TFI Global, the foreign affairs and geopolitical analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I'm your host, Atul Mishra. In this video, I will tell you about the frustrated CCP that might have assassinated its own PLA chief at the border with India. Let's begin. 4 months have passed since General Zhang Chudong was shown the door out of China's Western Theater Command, which is the communist nation's largest military command responsible for the lookout of Tibet, Xinjiang, Sichuan, Gansu, Xinjiang, Shanxi, Ningxia, and Yunnan apart from the borders with India. The Western Theater Command is the only theater in China that has suffered physical losses over the past 1.5 years. India has dealt some severe blows to China during this time, and the Western Command of the PLA has had to deal with it firsthand. So expectedly, the CCP was bound to come hitting down hard on one of its own. As it turns out, the hammer has struck already. On October 1st, which is also the founding day of the People's Republic of China, General Zhang Chudong died. The sudden death of General Chudong has raised many eyebrows among China observers around the world. According to a South China Morning Post report dated October 6th, which is the first report informing about the death of the general, the man died of cancer and gastrointestinal issues. He was 58 years old. However, not many are buying this version fed to SCMP by sources in China. It is a mighty possibility that General Zhang Chudong has been assassinated by the CCP for failing to handle the military standoff with India in a matter that Xi Jinping would have wanted. Consider this, it's still October, which means the winters are yet to set in with all their ferocity in China. General Chudong was merely 58 years old, and he was a top general in China. He was not fighting anybody. He had been removed from the Western Theater Command only 3 months ago. If at all, his retirement phase should have been going on splendidly. Yet, the man drops dead on the founding day of Communist China. What's even more intriguing is the fact that the Chinese Communist Party hides news of his death for a wholesome 3 weeks. Finally, when Chinese state media did announce the general's death on October 21st, they said Zhang Chudong, the former chief of the PLA's Western Theater Command, died from illness in Beijing on October 1st. The announcement provided no specifics about the illness that caused his death. According to the Epoch Times, the announcement came 20 days after the general's death, and such delays in China are considered a rare occurrence. If the general indeed died of natural causes, why did the CCP take 3 long weeks to disclose his passing away officially? Surely, something fishy is afoot in China. Most recently, Xi Jinping appointed General Wang Haijiang as the new commander of the People's Liberation Army's Western Theater Command. General Wang is the fourth commander to head the Western Theater Command after the Eastern Ladakh standoff began in May last year. Most recently, in July this year, Xi Jinping had appointed General Xu Qiling to head the PLA's Western Theater Command. However, this particular command is proving to be a tough nut for Jinping to crack. In a matter of 17 months, for the Chinese Western Theater Command to get 4 new commanders is unnatural and suggests that all is not well in Western China's PLA divisions. It must be remembered that the People's Liberation Army is the first and only line of defense in China. So whenever Xi Jinping gives effect to a new misadventure, whether it be against India, within China, against Taiwan, and the larger democratic free world, it is the PLA that has to suffer on an immediate basis. This has led to discontent rising among PLA ranks. China's Western Theater Command in particular has faced the brunt of Xi Jinping's larger-than-life ego, which is disallowing the PLA from resolving the border standoff with India. The Western Theater Command is well aware of its capabilities. It knows India has emerged as a mighty force and that taking it on is not easy and may just result in a humiliating loss for China. In which case, of course, Xi Jinping will go on a mass hanging spree of WTC generals, commanders and soldiers. Xi Jinping is taking up a war with his armed forces. As per Indian intelligence reports, Pakistani army officers are being stationed in the formation headquarters of China's People Liberation Army. Pakistan liaison officers have been posted in the headquarters of China's Western Theater Command and Southern Theater Command. According to a report by News 18, Colonel rank officers of the Pakistan Army have been posted at the Joint Staff Department of the Central Military Commission, which is responsible for combat planning, training and strategy of China's armed forces, and at the Ministry of State Security. Are we to believe that Pakistan is guiding the Chinese military? Has China fallen so low that it requires help from a failed terror state like Pakistan that India keeps punching from time to time? Absolutely not. The reality is that Xi Jinping trusts Pakistani soldiers more than Chinese little emperors and seems to have stationed them in the Western Theater Command to keep an eye on Chinese generals and commanders on his behalf. General Zhang Chudong was appointed as the Western Theater Command commander after China suffered humiliating losses against India at the Galwan Valley in June last year and across various strategic heights in eastern Ladakh in September 2020. India fought the Chinese with Tibetan Special Forces on its side, and the PLA sissies were left running helter-skelter for shelter. As such, General Zhang was given the task of comprehensively beating India to the ground. He failed miserably at his job, and the winter months proved to be a catastrophe for China along the Himalayas. Essentially, General Zhang failed Xi Jinping, and he now seems to have paid for the same with his own life.